In conclusion, I would like to state that we are in firm opposition of adopting a federal cap and trade policy as outlined in the American Clean Energy and Security Act. Congress should not pass any cap and trade bills presented at this time because it will only lead to more economic and environmental harm. It is not necessary for the United States to establish a new cap and trade policy in order to address the excess of greenhouse gas emissions because our current system, the Clean Air Act under the United States Environmental Protection Agency, is affecting at reducing carbon emissions already. According to the Center for American Progress, as Sarah stated, since the Clean Air Act was enacted, the EPA reduced overall pollution, air pollution, while the U.S. gross domestic product has risen 207%. The benefits of the American people of the Clean Air Act include mostly health benefits, such as asthma reduction, lower lung cancer rates, and greater productivity. Economic benefits are expected to reach nearly $2 trillion in 2020, exceeding any cost in more than a 30-to-1 ratio. It is not necessary to create an entirely new system for regulating carbon emissions. Implementing the proposed nationalization of the cap and trade policy would cost us so much time and money that it would enormously outweigh any benefits that would result from this policy. And indeed, there are many loopholes in the proposed system that would continue to exist if the policy was expanded. For example, it is unclear where to set a cap on carbon emissions to begin with, so it is difficult to regulate how much emissions should be reduced with the cap and trade policy. The free permit systems would essentially allow companies that pollute the largest to get the most amount of permits, discouraging them from developing innovative clean energy methods of production. In Europe, a free permit system actually led to an increase in carbon emissions and a hefty price tag for the consumers. The offsetting policy is faulty as well because companies get permits for not really doing anything to reduce carbon emissions. Like the example of the company in Indonesia who received offsets for cutting down an entire forest. It is reasonable to expect that if the cap and trade system were implemented nationally, the American companies would simply shift their jobs and production overseas in order to avoid the carbon cap and price of permits. The EPA has proven in the very recent past that it is capable of combating carbon emissions successfully. They recently passed a policy on January 2nd of this year, which created new standards for oil industries and power plants to regulate carbon emissions and to update their facilities to have greener production. The EPA gives industries enough time to adapt to new policies and are constantly updating and proposing new ideas and innovations for how to clean up the environment. In conclusion, America does not need to adopt a national cap and trade policy at this time. We should wait until all the faulty areas have been eliminated and the rough edges trimmed before adopting a policy that could be potentially as devastating as the cap and trade policy my opponent proposes. For these reasons, my partner and I stand in firm opposition of nationalizing the cap and trade policy.
Thank you.